Pistol now, and again, it's a really big deal. LDLC could potentially just close this map out straight away. Just like, get a 16-3 scoreline if they really lock this down. All starts here though on the pistol, and then goes push through the sewers. And that is not a pleasant sight for Shox. Halo gonna be rocking that 5-7. He usually would buy the CZ actually, but obviously swapping that out for the 5-7 now, good choice. And they are actually on the site, but the bomb is yet to go down, and the flank is coming in. We see Kyoshima making his way through kind of the B-long area. And look at this. Could even have pulled out the knife himself. And that's going to be all she wrote.
Two players surviving. They didn't win the duels. They didn't get the bomb plant. Not ideal there for 3D Max after a good start. Ooh, Kyoshima bringing out the P90. I just bought a Death by... What's it called?
Death by Kitty. Yeah.
Yeah, I just bought one of those today, actually. And I named it Magic Mushrooms.
Why?
Because it's all psychedelic and crazy. I don't know from first-person experience, of course. Although no one will believe that now, but honestly, I don't. I just thought it was appropriate as all. Okay, so LDLC with a strong start on the heavily favored CT side. Kyoshima with the Gatling gun. Gonna get two frags on this anti-eco. Nobody dead yet for LDLC. Only two players remaining here for 3D Max. The Juan Deeg does come out. Haven't seen one of those for a while. Ooh, that's a nice crossfire.
So three players left now and starting to get a little bit awkward. Happy does pick himself up the good old Tech 9. And Shark's going to pick up a kill with that P50. So things going all right now for the CTs. LDLC just got one player left. The old car pulls out the knife. Going to go for the stab. That's not going to happen, I'm afraid. Gonna have three players surviving there, so that's fine for 3D Max. Good result.
After that knife round, I'm surprised they bothered trying to use the knife again.
Right now, though, they should be buying pistols again. They're gonna need to eco again anyway. Well, they're gonna have to eco here to buy next round. They're gonna have a surplus of money now. Okay, they did buy a few things, but they still have a lot of cash.
Zarte's only gone with a Glock, and he has more money than anybody else, which is interesting.
He could easily have bought PDP.
He wants AWP there,
but he could still afford an AWP in the following round. So that's interesting. But I guess maybe he wants the Kevlar helmet, I guess, is probably the idea there. And I think he'll have just enough for both by not buying anything. So that's pretty smart, I guess. We'll have to see how the money works out exactly. Could do some math, but that's usually like me constructing a noose and then hanging myself with it. You know, cast the math, it's not good.
Do it. Hey, you've got to be brave, man.
I do it sometimes. And so far it's been going okay. But
you're not feeling brave today. I tried to get Dan to wear a paper bag earlier.
Yeah, I've done some crazy stuff, but that seems a little bit too... it's not that it's crazy, it's just that I don't like...
You don't trust me.
I don't like what would happen on the caption contest for that one.
A paper bag.
Yeah, I think the undertones, they're...
You don't know what I'm capable of while you're wearing a paper bag.
Yeah, let's move really, really fast away from this, please. Kyoshima is just kind of like going to sit there. That the old boost spot.
What is he doing?
He's trolling. It's got a smoke there being readied. Interesting. Wait, yeah, Zarte taking it.
He's still moving. Teammate's got to hand some assistance if he misses the second shot as well.
So that's really nice to find a quick pick here. Now, obviously, LDLC have gone for a very, very defensive setup now. They're all at the back of the sides. And they've left two on either side, but we'll have to see if 3D Max are going to be able to push in. Because right now, they've already got the pick, and they're already going to have a really huge advantage on the numbers.
Ooh, so look at this.
It's all about that execution and the coordination with the nades. So what we're looking for right now is 3D Max showing us that they have done their rehearsal on these set plays, because that's what this is all about.
What is he lining that up with, I wonder? Okay.
All right, this is nice so far. Natty gonna pick up the entry there through Long, and so far so good. They get the two kills without response for the players on that A site. And this is textbook stuff coming in from 3D Max. So far, they are unable to get the bomb down, but it doesn't matter unless Kyoshima is able to go huge and find three more kills. All of a sudden, does have the second. Just two more players left. Surely not. Kyoshima tossing over the incendiary onto the side. They still can't plant the bomb. This is kind of awkward now, all of a sudden. Kyoshima goes in. Does have a one-on-one. Oh, getting the shots. Just clipping onto. So are they missing the shot? They're both so low. How is this doable for Kyoshima? I don't know, but it is. Make his way back in through those flashes. How is he still standing at this point? And he will take down Zarte. This could be an embarrassment. He won't find the kill on the remaining player, but almost pulling off a 1-on-4. Unreal.
That was far too expensive for 3D Max. Do they have four players on the site versus two, was it?
It was four versus two. They got the two entries of the guys on A just immediately. And it was a 4-on-2 with them on the site.
This is definitely going to be a night for slog. Again, LDLC, a very strong team on Overpass when they're all alive, but great individual performances we're seeing here as well.
Yeah, and I mean, it wasn't as if he was just, you know, snapping their necks like really fast. They were genuinely missing a lot of shots against him, so that's not going to feel good for them right now, and giving Kyoshima way too many opportunities. And we can see the result, you know, just a Deagle on Disturbed, because he really wanted to have the money for the smoke, the flash, and the incendiary. So we'll have to see what they're able to do with this. Looks like they're lining up potentially another set play towards the B site, this time without having an opening kill as they did in the previous round, and without the firepower they had in the previous round. So it's going to be very interesting to see if this goes quite so well for them.
They have the AWP to open things up, but they are not being engaged right now. They're starting to push main. There is a frag on Happy. The counter flashes are coming in from the CT. We've got three on the site right now. They're using Molotov to control the space, but the smoke will stop that. And the bomb isn't going to go down once again. Choxy coming in now. Only two 3D Max players left. The bomb has finally gone down, and only Reflex remains.
At least the bomb is down, though, in this round. There it is. His head gets lopped off by Chox, and they secure it. So I did like some of those grenades that we saw from 3D Max. Obviously, though, they weren't in a position where they could get an opening kill. It would have made all the difference it did in the previous round. And it would have been hard for them to find it even, because LDLC were playing a very passive style. And I think, you know, they weren't really leaving 3D Max with many other options. And 3D Max gave a good go at that round. So I'm impressed that 3D Max, you know, have the plays to address situations correctly. But of course, whenever you're running a play against LDLC, they are really strong individually. It's always going to be difficult, no matter how appropriate your play is.
Yeah, and those favored M4A4s allowing lots of spray here for LDLC. Spray happy today. We've got two terrorist players pushing down a long area. Going to be facing off against Kiyoshima. First frag goes his way. The second frag, though, yes, it will. With that CZ as well, no players falling on that anti-eco for LDLC, and it is going to be 5-1. 3D Max with a little money in the bank. They're going to have a somewhat minimal buy here. We can see the bank starting to build for LDLC after losing all of no one in that previous round. So it's going to be an extra 5k in the bank for all of those players. And again, we've got the aggressive positioning here we're talking about. The flash coming in for Smiths. Going to be some blind players up top. And again, they retreat afterwards, which is what we mentioned before, and that's a kind of standard vintage play here for LDLC. Doesn't reward them on this occasion, but often does. And they've retreated all the way back to the bomb sites. But the fact that they've pushed so far often means that the T's have to clear areas out very, very slowly, and Happy's going to clear Zarte off the map.
So one way you can take advantages on this map as a CT is to play with forward positions. It does come at its own risk, but against really, really top-level teams, you're going to want to try to take risks like that to get edges in the right spots. But we'll hold that forward as we are seeing 3D Max pushing through the toilets now, and of course there is a very close player in Chox. He's going to get taken down. That's a good movement now from 3D Max as their chances to bust into the A site is increasing. But those smokes are going to definitely delay them, but they don't have much time on the clock at the moment. And LDLC know that this push has to just come in on A, and there's no other argument to be made. Next, those smoke is to actually dissipate, and the bomb flying there. They can't get in, just these re-smokes are so annoying. 20 seconds on the board. 15 seconds now to make this happen. Khan with a great pick, it's 2-on-2. They have to go in, and they've got to go in now, and they try, but the bomb's going to get dropped. And there it is, good defense from LDLC. But just to quickly finish my point is that LDLC know they're the better team. They know they've got better execution individual skills, so they don't have to play as risky a gameplay, even if it does lend some advantages here on a map like Overpass.
Do you feel like there needs to be an additional approach to the A bomb site? Because if they don't breach A via B, then there's pretty much only one entrance to it, and you can see what happens when you get continually cut off with smokes there.
Yeah, the only response I think is, and we see it from a lot of teams, is just smoking all the positions that they want to fight you from. So like they smoke your choke points off, but if you smoke the points that they have to actually catch you when you're going through their smokes, if you smoke off that and Molotov it off, then you can get through and you can just bum rush through. And we do see a lot of top teams going for plays like that to try to just force the issue on A, because otherwise we have that situation where they're just sitting there. They're sitting there, and they can't do anything.
Yeah,
so
in a way, A on this site is like B on Inferno. It's like the site names are the wrong way around, basically. Because yeah. B's the one where you can launch at least a two-pronged assault.
Yeah, definitely. Happy. We saw him do amazing things here against NIP in the grand finals of DreamHack Winter 2014. And still a reliable guy to get those kills with that AWP. But so far, 3D Max trying to just get some position here. And this is, again, the difficulty of this map. If the CTs want to play forward positions, they've got so many options. Working with these toilets and also the park area is really, really strong for the CTs. We can see how they got the bomb there. They're going to smoke it off. And it's all about the third player coming in from the B side to try to like find an angle to crush this this T aggression. Very tough angles to deal with here for the T's. You can see struggling to find the right place to look to as MBK picks off Reflex, and there it is. Kipshim will finish him off.
How many rounds do 3D Max need on this half?
I think they need at least five, I'd say.
I think they need seven.
Against LDLC, they're gonna need a huge amount of rounds, whichever way you look at it. But I feel like on this map, for how the map plays out, I feel like I think five is okay. It's pretty CT sided. And Happy doing happy business over by Long with that AWP, wrecking some faces. They do actually lose two players, so it's not a huge face wrecking without response. There is a small response, but it's not going to matter. LDLC is so rich, 9-1.
Three AWPs on LDLC side. But one thing to note there was Happy had the AWP and the P250 as backup. And if he had the CZ, he would not have been able to draw the gun in time to get that pistol frag there. So you can see instant changes there. Honest Guns back on the scene. It's a great day to play Counter-Strike.
So there's so many ways they can play with these AWPs. They can get really aggressive if they want, but they're just keeping some kind of middle of the road kind of aggression, not full out, but ooh, reflexing with the CZ, showing that it can still do some damage. And we'll find himself at AWP, but in comes MBK from the flank. Going to be able to spray down two players. It's a really, really big movement there from him. He's going to be able to give his team a decisive advantage here, and finding the last one in the toilets.
That pre-fire. Yeah, P250 is all over the place now. It's great.
Yeah, it's only $300. It's really cheap.
Yeah, it's always been a good gun. It's got really good recoil as well.
Yeah.
You can spam it fairly well without the recoil going absolutely nuts. Only requires a bit of control.
Good armor penetration. It's definitely a really good pistol.
3AWP. And that's Kiyoshima. Look at that timing on those keys. That was brilliant. Come on. That was good.
Yep. Yeah, it's really nice from Kiyoshima there in that position. The underpass area, the tunnel, the whatever you call it in your area of the world. The Kreek! Don't often see the Kreek come out to play, but when it does have some damage. So there you go, 3-on-3 now, the three AWPs remaining. Smith's still kind of forward by the toilet area. Gonna have to fall back now as it doesn't have any support. Could get attacked from either the park or the toilet side, so he's going to just get a better position. And with the AWPs as well, I mean, having those positions at the back of these sites with orbs is really good too on this map. It's not like it's too close range, really. You can get some great shots in.
3D Max with two smokes, but if they can't find the CTs, they have to gamble as to where to throw those smokes to cut off these AWPs, although I doubt they're going to be expecting to be up against the three remaining orbs here, which is also a factor. There is an angle where Smith is standing on the kind of park area, so you've got to be careful when you cross that final corner. Got the preemptive counter flashes coming in. That will reveal his position. Let's see if he gets smoked off. Indeed he does. Molotov coming in onto the site as well. Gets the first frag. Enough time to get the CZ out, and Smith is still broken by design. 11-1 LDLC.
Yeah, it's really interesting to see how many players will keep the CZ in their arsenal. As we already saw that MBK has switched his CZ slot for a 5-7. 5-7s are really good. Really, really good. And I'm surprised that we don't see more Tech 9s. But we'll have to hold that thought. We have Smith going for a very aggressive push with the AWP. I would have expected more plays like this. But so far, they haven't been super aggressive. But in comes the fire from MBK, going to stop the push immediately onto the site. In goes the smoke as well. Natu going to flash himself through there and find the angle. The shot cannot be connected by from Happy with that AWP. So with that great smoke over by the barrels, they have a good opportunity to get in this bomb site, but they are kind of lagging behind here. 3D Max, not super coordinated, but the bomb is going to go down. Shock still behind the barrels. I don't know if they know he's there. Oh, he's going to be able to help Smith get the kill onto Natu. And really, really incredibly good position here for Shocks. Disturbed reflex and can't just waiting really patiently.
Disturbed's position, though, he could have naded those barrels from that connector area. Let's see if Smith has got enough time to defuse the bomb here.
He's going to have to go for the hold here, I think. Just he's not going to go for it. This bomb is so far. It's now too late. And Smith going to go down.
Takes everyone down with him, though. Just too good with that big white and orange gun. 3D Max double their score to 2. And they're going to need all the remaining rounds here if they are to mount an offense on the second half. 2 AWPs now for LDLC, so slightly changing things up. $33,000 of equipment on them compared to the $21,000 of 3D Max.
Oh, that's a wonderful Molotov. Surprised that smokes can get rid of the Molotovs, but the water can't in the sewer area. But Sati going to make his play. Great shot there onto Happy that's going to punch a hole through onto the site of B. But he can't quite get through just yet. He needs some kind of support here. And he can get smoked off now. But oh my... Wow. That doesn't happen every day. Finding the stray bullet onto CT's head. And now we have a 3-on-2. So 3D Max might just be able to pull another round out. And we'll have to see if Sarte is going to be able to do much more with this Galil. So far, very deadly. Shock's not going to win his duel, so it's all on Smith and the AWP and the CZ. Definitely an awkward position here. He would do very well to even get one or two frags. He's got to like pop flash himself out there before he goes through the smoke. Does get wall banged. Really, really good map knowledge there from Zarte. That's going to be the third frag found by Zarte with that Galil, and all three frags were very nice and unconventional.
Yeah, and that's going to be another important round here for 3D Max. Again, the pistol's going to be key in the second half, but they do need to get this round as well. Kishima's going to pick up a third AWP, but Shoxi only with a FAMAS, which is interesting.
But here it is, Smith with the aggressive play on the AWP again. And there are the counter nades. And this is one of the reasons why pushing is so fun as the CTs, because you get to actually waste a lot of the nades of the CTs.
Oh,
that reaction. Beautiful.
Please.
Love it. And that was just a spot as well. I mean, he was just... I thought he'd be pretty safe going for a jump there, but Smith's too fast. Showing why he is the AWPer of LDLC, the dedicated AWPer. But this character over here, Happy, he is quite a good AWPer himself. He usually just picks it up in spots where he likes the position to use it. He's not super dynamic with it like you know Smith is supposed to be. But there will be spots and roles for Happy where he will pick that AWP up and he's going to be really deadly because he knows it to a science. So Smith's going to go aggressive again, finding himself a flick. It's like he's playing deathmatch at the moment, just running around.
Rambo, French Rambo on the scene right now.
You have to give him the bandana at the next LAN that you see him. Because if he's not, he should be wearing a bandana.
He should be wearing a bandana.
Joshman now finding a frag. It must be so frustrating playing against all these AWPs. Just how do you circumvent all these AWPs? Especially in these spots where, like, you only have so many nades as the T's. If you want to, like, try to push a site, you kind of want some nades left over to actually do that. But then, if you're afraid that there's an AWP around every corner and you kind of want to flash yourself in to at least safely take these angles, then by the time you get to the site, you don't have many nades left, if any at all. So it's pretty scary.
I know pros publicly say that they quite like overpass, but I mean, I don't see the point of taking off train if you add overpass, considering how lopsided this is. But we can get to that a bit later. As Greedy Max get off to a good start with two frags here, but Zata gets caught reloading and NBK will take him out. Reflex two frags though on Kiyoshima and NBK. Happy last man standing versus three. Four, sorry, takes out one. Doesn't have the bomb, so this is going to be a long and arduous task.
Might just be a very fun one though. Happy's still got a good chunk of armor left to his name. Gonna spot already one player and another one over by the squeaky door. So Happy not finding those one bullet frags that he really needs right now to make his situation a little bit easier. And he doesn't really have a safe way to get to the bomb. I mean, he'll have to take either the very roundabout way or go through squeaky, and they're kind of ready for this. They're ready for him to go through this tiny little gap. Look at this. Look at these positions. There's just no way. And Happy's going to go down. So the pistol being picked up by 3D Max, and it is very doable for them to find their way back into this match on the CT side. They're going to have some really good defenses or defensive setups on both sides, to be honest. LDLC have, they know all the grenades. They know how to play those heavy-hitting A-pushes where they don't care about your grenades, where they just smoke and Molotov you out. And that said, they can do that on C as well.
Yes, they've gone for the full force buy here, but they've almost been completely cleaned out by 3D Max. Only Shoxi remaining. So let's stay with him and see what he can do here. We've got Reflex on 19 HP, so he's going to need to get the hell out of Dodge. He is going to be running around with a teammate, so the trade frag will be possible should he fall.
Is he with Disturbed? Because he should really give his gun to Disturbed, to be honest.
He is. That is a good point, actually.
I mean, so that Disturbed can go first with the gun.
They have split up now, actually. Okay. But yeah, that would have been a good idea.
Because in a spot like this, I think one would even consider just playing the sites, like two on one side, one on the other, just so that you don't risk somebody being on a site with 10 HP. You know, because that's the nightmare situation here. That's how Shox makes this work, is he gets an early one-on-one and then finds a guy of low HP. So we'll have to see if he's able to do this. They are definitely evading him so far. But he's running out of time. Soon he's going to have to just go for the plant. And he's going to get caught on the side. So no comeback for Shox in that round. 12-5 the score, and 3D Max, they only lost two players in the end there, so that's quite manageable.
Yes, it is, and we'll see the full eco coming out for LDLC so they can buy in the following round. Although they have gone for a bunch of flashbangs here, so we may go for a fast play to try and get the bomb plant. Let's see what they do. Indeed, with Shoxi playing a bit behind, looks like they are going to throw flashes on site. But Natsu getting the first frag. They're stuck in the tunnel, the counter flashes will come out for the CT. They're going to get chopped down.
Natsu going for the ace, and he's going to find the ace. All stuck, all just and very neatly coming through, single file through the tunnel there. And the flashes from Shox are nice, but if they don't, if those flashes aren't perfect, then it's a really big tell. And your entire team's going to die like that. So 12-6, 3D Max now up against the AKs of LDLC. But LDLC having kind of invested a lot in the pistol in the round two rounds ago, with the pistols and having some nades, they don't actually have any nades now to play with.
Yes, so they are very, very lacking. And that is a big frag there, but Shoxi will even things out once again. Just running around towards the A-site on his own.
In theory, if 3D Max has perfect knowledge of the buy of LDLC, and they know that they don't have many nades. Although, we'll come back to this point, because Shox is going to take over the lobby, the bank area, and Naughty is going to have to try to find him out. And he's going to find the 1-on-1, he gets the kill. That's a really good play there from Naughty. Having that kill is a really big deal. Shox to stay alive there, it's going to be really hard to do this retake, but now obviously they're just going to constrict the position of Gentleman, and he's going to go down by Optimus. But yeah, just if you have like perfect knowledge of the opponent's buy, and you see that they have like 3 smokes and like 2 flashes or something, you don't really need to push that aggressively. Because if you just like with these sites the way they are, if you just hold them, if they don't have any nades to help them through onto the site, it's really hard. So you can just stay like very passive, and that can be really a nice way to react to that kind of situation.
The important thing here for LDRC is that they did get the bomb plant down, and they've basically got almost an identical buy this round to the last one. But you can see it's a bit of a different round for them. Happy going to just be hanging around the pipe area on his own as his teammates do start to take map control on the upper A.
I really like position. This. Look, we can see there's absolutely no nades left from LDLC. They had a few, but they used them all already, and they haven't even gotten close to a site yet. Happy does get the entry, and this has to happen for LDLC. They have to get these entries. There goes a nice smoke onto way. That's going to delay them a little bit. But already going down one player, this could just make this doable now for LDLC.
Yeah, with the AKs, it looks like LDLC are just going to rely on Angels here to get them through this round. We'll start to approach the A-bomb site with 3 men. Kishima shot down to 44 HP, which will help with the M4s of 3D Max. The counter flush is coming in, but 3D Max starting to run out of nades themselves. They do spot a few people there. Another counter flash going to slow LDLC down even more, but it's those nades and mollies that are going to do the big damage.
It's a nicely timed one there, but you can't actually. I like that incendiary. And you can see it's really an arduous task for that grenade to get inside. They line up, and he only gets one. Can't. Does take Smith down to 34 points of health, but still that's not going to be enough. Income. Zarthi and disturbed, but the bomb is down, so it's going to be a very hard retake. Happy's pretty healthy, his teammates aren't so much though, so it could be doable. Here they're going to go for the split, or actually no, they're going to go both through bank, and here we go, disturbed, they're going to play up first, man. Very good now, taking the shots and falling back, and they get it. But wow, that was a really close round actually. As you said, relying on those angels, it's all they had. That's the only thing that they had going for them, is just getting angels.
Yeah, but they were confident that they would come out on top, and come out on top they did. Again, they had the stronger weapons to go for those angels as well, and it worked out in their favor. So these small changes, which I forgot to mention, these small changes to overpass that happened recently, you can see it's a lot harder for the CTs to hold from the kind of pit area there as they have to jump up now. But we have aggressive positioning from the CTs. We've got a 3-man push in upper A. Naughty with assistance from Khan will take down Shoxi, and they start to retreat in the same way that LDLC do. They're going to be paranoid. You can see how passive they are in the upper area now. Going to slowly start to take map control and work out where the CTs are and are not. But yeah, those changes to the kind of CT spawn area and the pit where you have to jump up to peak, it kind of exposes your position a bit more and makes life a bit more difficult for the CTs. So, you know, if you can make it that far and get the bomb down as T, then it's easier to hold the sights. But again, it's still an uphill struggle to get into that position in the first place. Now, this is a map that has changed wildly since it first came out. You can see where Zarte is. Up to the left, there was an additional kind of overpass over the sewer, which allowed the T's to advance the site, but it was getting rushed a bit too often, so they removed that. Zarte will start the hold against NBK there with the frag, but his position is known there. He is kind of stuck. They're going to push the tunnel with a grenade. Trade frags do come in. Smith's only man standing for his team now. And he will fall to disturbs along with his teammate Happy.
I really like that spot from Zarte. It's one of those spots where you're the way that you feel is that, okay, I'm really committed there, because as soon as I should get like a very small edge on the reaction time. I'll see them first, because they should in theory be looking to the left, because the left is like for the CT is a safer spot, because the CT can have a peek and then fall back safely. But Zarte's position is so exposed, he has to make frags happen there. You can see the eco come in through the sewers, and let's see if they can make it work this time. Last time Naughty got an ace. There we go, Kyoshima is going to get Nati down, but he did take two players with him, so it's still going to be really hard. And a really nice position here for the Stab as well. They've got the angles. The angles here. But yeah, just again, to finish the point, you know, Zarte in that position, as soon as he's found out, they know exactly where to look. There's no safety, he's totally exposed. And so, but it's nice to mix those in sometimes. You don't always want to be predictable, and that's a nice mix. I like it.
So we've got two Galils coming out for LDLC, the AWP on Smith's as well. So we've gone from three AWPs on the CT side to one, at least for the time being. No AWP for Zarte this round. He is going to be rocking the AK for the time being. 3D Max closing the gap. Only a four-round deficit now on the stronger side, the CT side of this map. We'll see who gets the first opening frag. Reflex in a strong position to flank, especially with his teammates covering his back here. So we'll see what happens. Disturb does take down NBK first, but the A-bomb site has been exposed, and they're going to walk straight into it pretty fast here. So this could be terrible for 3D Max.
Yeah, the gamble not paying off, and LDLC planting the French flag in the A bomb site next to Optimus. The bomb down. Is he going to make some efforts here? Actually making amazing efforts. There's two frags. And that's going to be a really, really nice retake coming in. It's just Shocks left to try to save this for the French side, but he won't be able to do that. And the bomb is going to get defused. So 3D Max really making this work. And LDLC, they had all the time in the world to have like nice post-plot setup and all this kind of stuff, but they just kind of crumbled against Nati.
3D Max made that look easy. LDLC literally walked into the site and planted the bomb with three players, and then they all fell with only one player falling for 3D Max. So that was a bizarre round, to say the least. And 3D Max getting back and further into this. They're going to force LDLC onto the eco now. We have a mixture of weapons, two CZs and two Deagles, P250 on Happy. So let's see where we can go with this. They're going to just be rushing through the middle, and have they even been heard by the CTs? I think Reflex has noticed something, so he's going to be dashing back towards the site where I don't know if there's anyone covering it once again for 3D Max. Are we going to see another plant here for LDLC?
Might just see a plant, but the rounds, I don't know. Nice position there for Reflex already up on the flank. They're coming from all sides at the moment. Natu opening it up onto MBK, and this is looking very, very nice now for LDLC. They're very close to making this retake. Sorry, 3D Max, they're very close to just making this retake happen, and there it is. They do get it, defuse it super fast. And but the thing is that whilst that may look kind of bad from one sense that LDLC only got a single frag, getting the bomb down was their objective, and that was the highest expectations they had, and they achieved that. So now they're going to have the money that they need, and should they lose this, I think that they're going to be able to force up as well. So 3D Max now in a very important position. They have to take this one, because we're getting really close to this match being closed out, and this is match point for LDLC, let's not forget.
You can see they've changed their position now. They've left the CT South, sorry. They've left Long A early and put two people in mid, so I don't know what to stop LDLC from walking into sight again. Disturbs wins the duel with Happy. Battle of the spray downs.
And that was Happy did the move that Shocks did on Dusty and Short that we talked about before. Same principle. And this is exactly what they needed to have happen. Did you see that pop flash, by the way, I think from Zarte? Was it not? No, it was Natu, so I think it was. Over by the B-Long area. For those of you that caught that, that was really, really nice. Gonna have to copy that one. But here we go. It looks like they are setting up for an A push. In go the smokes. This is going to be a big tell right now, but it's all about the counter grenades. Can they hit those flashes? Can they make LDLC as blind as possible going in? Thing is, though, is that can't see a single thing. Jumps through the smoke, really timely, only gets a single frag, and Kyoshima will get the bomb down. 3-on-3 in for LDLC. Oh, that's beautiful there. Beautiful from Kyoshima. Gets one through the wall, and it's all falling apart for 3D Max. In comes Disturb to save the day, but it's going to be a Shocks that silences him, and Shocks has been playing really well in some of these key situations, despite having a low amount of frags.
Getting the important ones.
Exactly. The scoreboard rarely tells the real tale of how things are actually going. 14-11, LDLCO, a mere 2 rounds away from taking this 2-0 against 3D Max and progressing in the G2A.com Cup for a chunk of that $10,000. And this is an interesting boost here. I don't think I've seen this too commonly.
I think they're just going for
freestyle,
a two-pronged attack rather than a boost. So they get an instant trade there. But it doesn't work out as both of them fall anyway.
And now Nati is left with his with a very precarious situation. One of two. And he's going to go down as well. So LDLC on the brink of taking this one. And doesn't look like they're having too many troubles at the moment. 3D Max definitely had quite a few good opportunities to actually win this one as well. I mean, we had that situation where, you know, some of these B takes didn't quite go the way that they should have done, or too much damage was done on their T side. They had a decent T side, I think, but could have squeezed out a couple more rounds, much like the Dust 2 match. But Khan going to go with the underpass push here with that AWP. Often, this is very disruptive to the T's play, and in fact, it proves to be no different this time as well, as MBK is going to get taken down by that play. And now they can fall back, and they have an advantage. They can just take those passive positions, and really, they're laughing at this point. It's all down to RDLC's ingenuity on the smokes and the flashes to get them in the sights now.
Are they going to try and walk into the sights again? Are they expecting it to be empty again? They've got two frags.
Oh.
Looks like Kiyoshima has realized something about those usual CT positions, especially with the changes there, where you're kind of forced to take that position. Two wall bangs in a row, and Zarte is going to be the last man standing here for 3D Max against Match Point. This is not looking good for them at all. I think we're going to see LDLC going through to the next round. 2v1 now. Zarte, everything to play for, but no kit as well. He has no time, no helmet either. He is running out of everything right now. One man left to find, but 7 HP versus the AWP.
He's going to go for the hold.
Find himself a kit.
Here we go. And there it is. Smith's going to take him down. And 16-11 final score.